Again, I'm Sid, and today I would be answering a viewer's question. It has been asked to me by a viewer named Fruity, and she asks us which is a better phone to buy, the Oppo F1S or the Moto G4 Plus. Now, both these phones are available for under 20,000 rupees in the Indian markets, and I've reviewed these phones in the past. You can check them out too. And a lot of you have been asking me this question in the comment box below as well. So I decided to answer that in this edition of Ask 91. Now, I would be comparing these two phones in various sections, and I'm going to do it very quickly. However, let me give you one warning that if you are after specifications, there is not much of a comparison between these two phones. There is a clear winner. However, if you have a specific use case, then the things are a bit different. Having said that, let me now compare these phones. Starting with the design. I do not really appreciate the design of Moto G4 Plus. It's a very compact phone, it's a very good looking phone. However, it does not match the exquisite design that Oppo F1S offers. It uses plastic while Oppo F1S uses metal. It has a very odd fingerprint scanner placement. There's a fingerprint scanner that looks like a home button but does not act like one. On the other hand, Oppo F1S has a fingerprint scanner inside a home button, which makes more sense to me. Also, the mic placement of Moto G4 Plus is not very cool. So, designing goes to Oppo F1S for using premium metals, giving you a metal body. And apart from that, it looks a lot like the iPhone, which maybe, you know, some people might have an issue with it. However, the designing is decent nonetheless. Heading to display, Oppo F1S offers you an HD display, which should be sufficient for most of you. However, Moto G4 Plus kills it with a full HD display on board. Now, the thing is, when you pay that much money, you do expect a full HD display to be there on the phone. Coming now to performance, there is not much of a comparison here. Oppo F1S uses a MediaTek processor, which has 3GB of RAM on board, and the performance is good enough. However, the performance of Snapdragon 617 processor on Moto G4 Plus is outstanding for the price bracket it is being offered at. And if you look at the benchmarks, you're gonna get the same results. Moto G4 Plus outclasses the Oppo F1S both in terms of benchmark performance and in terms of real-life performance. And the reason it does so, prime reason, is because of good software optimization. Which now brings us to the software of these two phones. Oppo F1S runs on Android Lollipop and it has its own version of Android called ColorOS atop it, which gives you cool gestures to start with. It is a very colorful operating system. It does seem inspired from iOS a lot, but it is decent, though it does lack an app drawer. However, Moto is a champion when it comes to software. It gives you stock Android software in its purest form. It gives you a Nexus-like experience for half of its price. And that is the reason that makes it very popular among certain sections of people, especially those who love Android. Apart from that, Moto G4 Plus runs on Android Marshmallow on board. And according to my estimates, or my guesstimates rather, it will surely receive the update to the next Android version, Android Noga. I cannot say the same thing about a phone that is running on Android Lollipop, the Oppo F1S to be precise. So in terms of software, it's a clear winner again. Now let's talk about cameras, and this section is the one that can tilt the show in the favor of Oppo F1S. The rear cameras are more or less equal in terms of quality, even though Moto G4 has a more megapixel count, it has a laser autofocus on board, and also it has a bigger aperture. However, when you turn to the front camera, the equation changes completely. Oppo F1S has a 16 megapixel front camera, and with a 2.0 aperture, which I believe can, you know, outperform many phones in this category with their prime cameras contesting. Basically, the front camera of Oppo F1S is better than the rear camera of many other phones in this price bracket. Now I'll pause for a while and let you see some camera samples on your screen. Lastly, the battery life. Both the phones are almost equal in terms of battery capacity. Oppo F1S does have a little bit more of it. However, it does not make that much of a difference. Yet, due to the poorer resolution, Oppo F1S does outperform the Moto G4 Plus. However, the difference is marginal. So I would call it a draw here, and I would say that both the phones have good battery life. But now you know everything about the phone. And now the big question is, which phone should you be buying out of these two? Well, Moto G4 Plus does seem to offer more in terms of performance and software, and it would appear that Oppo F1 S is just a good front camera phone with mediocre specifications at best, right? True, but the thing is, many people just want that. If you are like me and most of the pictures that you click are selfies, or if you are a person who does not play hardcore games and does not mind the difference in processing, or if you are a person who does not mind the colorful operating system and does not like stock Android as it is, Oppo F1 S is rather decent. And I don't want to be sexist or anything, but it's a very good phone for girls is what I'll say, who use their front cameras more than the back ones. However, if you ask me personally, I would have picked up Moto G 4 Plus. And there are three reasons for it. Number one, 617 is definitely a better processor than the MediaTek that is on the Oppo F1 S. Number two, it is future-proof. With Android Marshmallow already on board and Android Noga, you know, probably arriving on Moto G 4 Plus soon, I would rather buy a phone that would last me for a couple of years than a phone that, you know, would run outdated software. And lastly, and this is the biggest one, when you pay 17,000 bucks, you do expect at least a full HD display on your phone. And the HD display on the Oppo F1 S is kind of a bummer. So I told you which one would I pick. I have told you what all to look for in these two phones, what is good, what is bad. So once you make up your mind, you can go to 91mobiles.com and get the best deal in town and buy your phone. Meanwhile, if you are still confused, post your questions in the comment box below. I'd be happy to answer them. If you haven't already, do subscribe to our channel. I'm on Twitter right now. You can follow me there. Like this video, share this video with your friends. My name is Sid. Keep seeing me. Ciao.